Hey, it's Paul from Wondershare Mobile Trans, and it is really good to see you back on the channel. And today we're going to tackle something that we get quite a lot of messages about, and that is that people seem to be having a lot of problems with the chat app Viber. So we will go through some of the most popular problems that people are having, and hopefully by the end of today's video you will know how to fix those problems. But before we carry on, if you're new here to the Mobile Trans channel, then why not subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any of the videos that we upload, because we upload tips, tricks, unboxings, we do it all here at Mobile Trans. So why not go ahead and subscribe, and let's get on with the video. This video will be about trying to help you out with those problems that you have with Viber. And like I mentioned in the intro, we get a lot of questions about this over on our Facebook page and our Twitter page, and even in our YouTube comments. People are always asking us what are the best solutions to some of the most popular problems that people have with Viber. So we will get into that. But before we start by giving you these tips and tricks, what we're going to suggest is that you actually back up your Viber chats. And you might be sat there thinking, how do I back up my Viber chats? Well, luckily for you, we have a solution called MobileTrans. MobileTrans is a piece of software that allows you to back up your Viber chats, your WhatsApp chats, it allows you to restore your iPhone, and it even allows you to move your WhatsApp chats from an Android to an iPhone or vice versa. So if you've not downloaded this app, go ahead and download it from the official MobileTrans website. And if you look in the description below, you will see a link that will take you to that official site. Okay, so once you've downloaded that MobileTrans software, the first thing you'll need to do is then go and open up the software and have a little look around it yourself. But when you're ready to back up your Viber chats, what you'll need to do is on that left-hand side, just click on the WhatsApp backup option. In here, you will see a list of apps that you can actually back up the chats for: WeChat, Viber, WhatsApp. But of course, for this one, you will need to click on Viber. The next thing to do is then go and get your phone and connect it to your computer. And just make sure that the cable that you're using works, because your phone will need to stay connected for the entirety of the process. Once you click next, your phone should be automatically detected by MobileTrans, and it will show you what it can back up. And the next step might be a little bit difficult. All you have to do is go and click start. It is that simple. Click start in that bottom right hand corner, and depending on how many chats or how much data you have to transfer to your computer, it may take a little bit of time, or it could be done instantly. But just sit back and relax, and then MobileTrans will do all the magic in the background. Okay, now that all your chats are safe and secure and backed up, we can go through some troubleshooting to help you with some of the most common problems that people have with Viber. And believe it or not, one of the biggest problems that we get asked about all the time is that we get asked, why are my messages or my pictures not sending through the Viber app? And of course, Viber, as we already know, takes advantage of mobile data and Wi-Fi, and can't work without being connected to either one of these methods. And sometimes it is a really easy fix that you may have just knocked off your Wi-Fi by mistake if you're at home, or if you're out and about, your mobile data just might not have been switched on. So you can solve most of the problems by just switching on your Wi-Fi or your mobile data, and there we go, it should work. But there is also another fix, mostly used for iOS users. If you're using this iOS app and having these problems, first of all, go and grab your iPhone and open Viber, and then head into the settings. When you're here, you'll need to find the privacy tab, and then find collect analytics. And then when you found that button, you just need to click disable. For some reason, this helps messages and images send a little bit better on the Viber iOS app. So if you go and disable those analytics, then hopefully your messages will now start sending. The next issue with Viber is one that I have myself, and it really irritates me. And it's the fact that sometimes that your Viber app will just not call. By this, I mean, if you're getting an incoming call, then you can't hear that ring on the Viber app. And of course, your phone might be set to do not disturb or on to silent. And that is absolutely normal. Those calls would not come through. But in many cases, especially for me, this isn't the case. My phone would be on loud, and usually your phone won't ring. What will happen is that Viber will send you a notification to say that someone is calling you, but you can't hear it ring, and that's no good. So let me show you how you can actually go ahead and hear that ring. So to solve this, go to your Wi-Fi settings, choose advanced, and check keep Wi-Fi on when screen time's out. sometimes it's just a point where your phone is not actually using Wi-Fi when your screen is locked. So that is a really easy fix. And that is the really easy fix for Android if you're using Viber on there. But with iPhone, it's just a little bit different. So this is what you need to do for that. You can choose notification settings inside your iPhone settings app. So what you'll need to do is go into the Viber app in the settings, click on notifications, and then you should see something that says go to alert style. Here you can choose either alert or banner. This now means that you will be able to hear those Viber messages as they come through onto your iPhone and hopefully never miss a call again. And as we're talking about incoming calls on Viber, there's also a problem where sometimes if you're getting a video call, it will just not work. And video calls at the moment where we are in life are really important to get this issue fixed. We've had reports of this not working on iPhones and Android phones, so hopefully what I'm going to tell you will help you out. And the first thing you need to do, of course, is open Viber and go into the settings. When you're inside those settings, just have a little look around and find calls and messages. And then select Viber in calls. This then allows your phone to receive those incoming calls when somebody decides to give you a little call or video call on the Viber app. And to allow those video calls, all you have to do is just select on there as well. And now when someone sends you a video call that is incoming, that should be absolutely perfect. But sometimes Viber can mess up the settings just a little bit. So it's always important just to go into settings every now and then and make sure that everything we've told you in this video is still checked and is still sat in the exact same way to make sure your Viber app works perfectly. There we go. There are some fantastic solutions there to help you with your Viber app and make sure it works to the best way it possibly can. And remember, what we spoke about at the start of the video was that MobileTrans software. So if you need to back up your Viber chats, you can do that through the MobileTrans software. And if you want to restore your iPhone, save WhatsApp messages, or move WhatsApp messages from an iPhone to an Android or vice versa, then why not go and download that MobileTrans software, where if you look in the description below, you can find the link to make sure you download that properly. If you enjoyed this video, why not give it a like, share it with a friend, and of course, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any of the videos we have coming up in the next couple of weeks. And if you do all of that, we will see you on the next video.